Could it be high noon for the high street? Each week, over 100 shops are biting the dust.
The retail expert, Mary Portas, is warning that UK high streets have reached crisis point.
More than 1 in 7 shops stand empty.
The government asked me, Mary Portas, to take a look.
If you take away the heartbeat, the high street, you take away more than shops. You take away a community.
It's a massive challenge. Some say it's impossible, but I believe it's worth fighting for.
This isn't a makeover. This isn't a rags to riches. Oh, Mary with her magic wand. This is reality, and this is going to take a few years.
So I came up with a 28-point plan, the Portas Review, and the government asked towns to bid for money to help revive their high streets.
That's the goal, that's the dream.
Nearly 400 towns applied to become a Portas pilot. I want to go beyond my government role and help 3 of them on the ground, documenting the process. Tonight, I'm heading to the quintessential seaside town of Margate. It suffered some of the worst shop closure rates in the country.
Margate's shit.
Diabolical.
This is blow up and start again, I think, personally.
I want to lend a helping hand, but my TV cameras are ruffling some feathers.
But why is this girl so angry?
Well, yeah. You want to come in with me without the cameras and
yeah,
we can talk?
Yeah, but why?
She's about to walk out of the place. The meeting's in half an hour. We're going to miss the biggest opportunity this town's had for 10 years, for Christ's sake.
Before package holidays became affordable to the masses, Britain's seaside towns were thriving. One of the South Coast's premier beach destinations was Margate.
9 miles of glorious golden sands, just waiting to be played on, laid on, marooned on, or even buried on.
But, as with so many of the UK's seaside rendezvous, Margate has been in decline. Today, the town still has the sandy beaches, bucket and spades, and the fish and chips. It also has the Turner Contemporary Gallery, which draws up to 2,000 people a day. But these visitors aren't going to Margate's High Street.
What do you think of Margate?
Margate's shit.
Sometimes I can go all day and not get a customer.
Margate High Street used to be absolutely chocker. You could not move up here. I mean, this shop, there used to be 6 people serving in this shop. Now it's just me.
When you walk down the high street now, it looks like a war zone.
Wanting to stop the rot, a group of locals have formed a dedicated town team. They successfully bid for a £100,000 government grant to help their high street and for Margate to become one of the Portas pilots.
We're all a bit stunned by what's happened. Totally delighted, I have to say. We are all going to work together to regenerate this town. Margate's going to get much better very quickly now.
And I'd like to help them make it better. I've nothing to do with how they spend their money, but I can offer advice. Once the premier destination for London day trippers, Margate is on the Kent coast, an hour and a half from the capital by train.
We've made the front cover of the Isle of Thanet Gazette, saying Mary Portas will be in Margate on Tuesday to listen to traders' plans to save the high street. And a lovely, lovely quote from the town team chairman, Robin, saying Mary will be here and it's up to us to show that Margate has the energy and goodwill to make this happen, which is great, you know, because if I haven't got the town team, you know, wanting to really make change, then this will be an uphill struggle.
I'm happy to read that because there's also bad press about my arrival. Some locals are concerned about negative TV portrayal, restrictive filming contracts, and confusion about whether or not I'm working for the government, which I'm not. There's more unhappiness on the town team's Facebook page, which asks whether the desires of the TV production company are being placed above the needs of a community in transition. I've got a lot of smoothing out to do.
Here we are, arriving at Margate. You couldn't get greyer. Raining.
For now, I want to assess what Margate has to offer potential visitors.
It's a lovely old station. So I'm just arriving from my seaside holiday. Oh dear. Got the worst kind of grey 60s tower block. I want to go to the high street. Oh, what's that? Dreamland.
This is Dreamland, what used to be a thriving cinema, bingo hall, no longer. And that used to be Dreamland Fairground, which is long gone.
With 20 acres of holiday fun, Dreamland Margate caters for the most exacting taste in thrill.
So all your real holiday activity, like Dreamland and Butlins, just went?
Yeah.
OK. No, and then the shops died after that, did they?
The shops, yeah.
Not all seaside towns are on their knees. The key to success is offering something unique to tourists. Padstow in Cornwall is known for being a foodie's paradise. Over in Suffolk, Southwold boasts colourful beach huts and boutique shopping. And Brighton in Sussex has its famous pier that attracts over 4 million people a year. Since 2011, Margate has been blessed with the Turner Contemporary Gallery, but visitors just aren't making the short journey across the road to the High Street.
So why would you come to the High Street? What would bring you to the High Street?
To be honest, nothing.
Oh, Ken. Before I get out, he told me that they do all the drug dealing at the top of the multi-storey car park. Which is really lovely to know.
Before going to a meeting with Margate's town team, I want to feel the pulse of some of the surviving high street shops.
How's it going?
Rubbish.
Is it?
really rubbish. It's what? A joke. In 4 years, it's diabolical. This is blow it up and start again, I think, personally.
Hello, darling. Blimey, how long have you been in here?
I've been here 50 years, yeah.
Now, where do you want that to go, sweetie?
Straight
down the front. Shall we just hang on 2 seconds? I'll do that for you. What's your name?
Dolly.
Hi, I'm Mary. You run this on your own, this shop, do you?
No.
Who helps you?
Brother.
Your brother, where's he?
Hospital.
Okay, well, I'll probably see you again, Dolly.
Thank you.
Take care. Thank you. Bye.
Dolly may be showing Dunkirk spirit, but many shopkeepers have given up. Of the High Street's 108 shops, 28 are lying vacant.
Look, shut. 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 Oh, dear. This is an omen, this weather.
I can't help thinking if the landlords started offering reduced rents and we could capitalise on the Turner Gallery footfall, it could spark the beginning of a long-term recovery. I take a look at the entrance to the High Street on the seafront and I'm surprised to find an X-rated sweet shop.
Who buys those? What if kids come in and pick those up, Billy?
Well, it's humour, isn't it?
Oh, stop it. Who goes out and eats that? That's what I want to know.
The girls, mainly.
Is it the girls?
Yeah.
She's nodding in the background.
Oh. It's a very good seller, especially if hen weekends.
I've never, ever been in a sweet shop where you have a top shelf in a sweet shop. For sweets, Billy's Wobbly Willies.
People coming in, it's a nostalgic thing. Yeah, they look at it and they go, oh, look, brilliant. Donuts, rock.
Yeah.
And saucy lollies and stuff. But then I can't sell ice cream to seagulls in the winter. How do I keep the money coming in to justify a business like this all the year round? That's genuinely my problem.
Margate's town team are holding a public meeting to discuss how to save the high street in, of all places, the old Woolies.
It's interesting, the town team have set themselves up here, which is brilliant. But it's interesting that the devastation Woolies did when it closed. How many towns that I've been to where they said when Woolies went, it was the start of the rot.
Before the meeting, I pop in to see town team chairman Robin.
Tonight's our first public event that we're holding, where we're letting everybody know officially what we're doing.
Because I think, you know, it's really important that we work together to try and really harness the vision and leverage as much as I can do for you guys.
No, we're really excited. You know, we've got some really public-spirited and, you know, community-minded people on our team. So, yeah, it's...
OK.
Whenever you want, we'll be there.
OK.
But I start to find out how unhappy some people are about the arrival of me and my cameras.
I've heard through the grapevine that there are people against you, and I don't understand why.
I'm hearing that there's a couple of people going around and telling people not to speak and work with me. Have you heard anything?
I have. They said that for some reason you're not able to come to the meeting.
Unless they open up access, I can't do anything.
They need to open the door to people from the outside.
I'll try and catch you later if I get in.
I really want my cameras in that meeting, so I head off to see the town team at Woolies.
Robin?
Yes.
Hi.
Hello.
Is it all the town team here now?
Not yet, no. We're waiting for the rest to come. We're just going around getting chairs and stuff in the church.
Robin, I've been hearing that I'm not allowed in tonight to the meeting.
What
about three or four?
Can we turn these off, actually, whilst we're doing it? Because this really isn't fair on us.
What's not fair? Why are you not letting me in with my cameras?
You are. But what's happened is the owners of Woolworths haven't given permission.
But why would you not? I'm documenting this.
It's the landlord is saying they don't want the cameras to come in.
Why is this girl so angry? Why is she not speaking to me? I mean, what do you... The whole point, why isn't she coming out now and talking to me if we can't film in there?
You want to come in with me without the cameras and we can talk.
But why? Why do you not want the cameras? What is it that
Robin,
you don't want
you
the
have to stop
for?
This. If they're filming, then you're not allowed to answer this clearly, are you, without the cameras?
Do you not want this to work with me?
Yeah, we do want to work with you. We've made it very clear we want.
You want the town to?
I would like you to turn the cameras off, please.
Can you turn the cameras off?
I've come to Margate to offer advice about rejuvenating the high street.
Look, shut. 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 This is an omen.
Although Margate has won a £100,000 grant from the government, locals are sceptical about how much difference this will really make, and mistakenly they think the money is something to do with me.
Is it about you or is it about Margate?
I'm hoping it's about Margate.
No, it ain't. Not £120,000. That don't do nothing.
No, that's not mine. I'm not paid a thing. I'm not paid a penny. I'm doing this because I believe...
What you're doing here, for £120,000, that can't even open a shop.
That's the government, that's not me.
It's right now, isn't it?
And my day is about to go from bad to worse.
I've had my office ringing me saying that our major trade magazine has been contacted. Someone's been complaining about the way that I've been working, and I've had the government office as well calling and saying that someone's been saying that we're not behaving appropriately. Well, it's just de-energising me. It feels really, really ugly, and I'm not sure how much difference I can make if I've got the town against me, imagine that.
I really need to get my cameras into that meeting tonight and win people round.
Billy?
I asked Billy for help.
Billy, have you got 2 secs? Listen, I don't know, but I'm not being allowed into this meeting tonight with my crew, and I just...
Come and have a cup.
No, I don't know, I feel rejected. Don't be nice, I'll get upset. Are they
willing in? We seek the advice of Margate's ex-mayoress and town team member, Iris Johnson.
I think there was some confusion about how involved you were with this particular, you know, film crew that had come down. I would have thought the government had said
the government know I'm filming. Yeah, but I'm not here on behalf of the government. The government aren't working with me on it.
I don't know why it all got them and us. We should have been embracing you coming and delighted you're paying attention to us. We want to get this right. We don't want to be shown as, you know, country bumpkin village idiots down here.
You have my word. I am here to document the journey. Do you know what my goal is? For people across the country to see if we don't get our high streets back, the effect it has on our community, our well-being and our lives.
I was of the opinion that Mary wasn't aware that there was a certain amount of antagonism that had crept in and a lot of misunderstanding had been going on.
Actually, I'm getting very upset.
Mary, if your film crew aren't allowed in there, the only thing that will happen is we'll have £100,000 from the government that no one will ever know anything more about, except that we'll get a few streets cleaned and a few shop windows done up and whatever. But if you're involved, we're going to get an awful lot more.
You're not going anywhere. You're kidnapped. We've got you here and you're staying. This, I'm sure, is a complete and utter misunderstanding.
Billy goes off to fight for my cameras to be let in.
Hello? This woman's about to leave here. We're going to miss the biggest opportunity this town's had for 10 years, for Christ's sake. Everybody wants to hear what she's saying. The meeting's in half an hour. She's about to walk out of the place.
With the meeting about to start, Billy runs off to talk to the organisers.
OK, I've just spoken to the powers that be. I've told them what the position is. You've got 5 minutes to get your act together. If you've got any issues, you're going to have to discuss them afterwards. But at least let the lady be here and let her answer the questions. And that's it, and they've okayed it.
It's got to be good,
isn't it? Oh, this could turn into a bum fight.
Well, yeah.
Finally, after a lot of haggling, I get the permission I need and I'm allowed in.
Have a little bit of hush, just for a moment, please.
Town team member Richard gives me a nice introduction.
And Mary, you are warmly, warmly welcome.
Thank you very much. I'll take it, thank you. This is not about me. This is about Margate. I don't know the answers. My God, I might be queen of shops. I'm bloody well not queen of the high streets yet, let me tell you. The next few months are going to be tough. Now, the downside in some of you is that I've got cameras doing this with me. And let me tell you why cameras are doing this with me. They're here to show the journey for all other 378 towns who applied and will not get this, have not got 100,000 and have not got me trying to help coming to their town. And if we put this on Prime TV, people will come. Now, that's a decision you've got to make. So we either let the cameras in with me or I go back on the train and some other town gets it. But I'd be very sad if it wasn't you, Margate. So let's go for it, shall we, all together. Thank you very much. Thank you.
At last, I seem to be winning over Margate residents. Or maybe not. It seems some people may have misinterpreted my turn of phrase.
In a phrase that many shopkeepers consider to be blackmail, Porter's added, so we either let the cameras in with me or I go back on the train and some other town gets it, which they would. In brackets, the money. That is not what I said.
I meant, of course, the publicity. It isn't in my power to give or take away the government money. My mood doesn't improve when I start reading unpleasant postings on Facebook.
I mean, it's just vile and heinous. But they call me Queen Mary, and then there's really a homophobic, horrible line after that. I mean, they're just sick. How can you go into that? You know, maybe there was a bit of me that thought they'll love me coming in here, and they didn't. You know, so that was, you know, something I have to sort of take on the chin. And you know, hopefully I'll be able to go back in and start again as if none of it's ever happened. Kind of.
Given the upset and confusion there's been, the town team and I decide to have a break working together on the programme.
Thank you.
Destination Margate, Belle of Kent, situated on the flat, fertile land of the Isle of Thanet.
Back in their heyday, British seaside towns drew huge crowds with entertainment for all ages. With the top entertainers of the time touring the coastal venues, going in towns like Margate was comparable to London's West End.
Thank you, Dickie.
But with the music halls and other key attractions now closed down, Margate is lacking a focal point for good old-fashioned fun. Margate's glory days gives me an idea on how to bring back the crowds and boost the high street. There's a limit to what I can achieve on my own, but I can still brainstorm ideas with my team. We're determined to bring the fun back to Margate.
What I was thinking of is whether we could take the high street and kind of create an inland pier. So the high street becomes where the pier activity would be.
Yeah.
What happens is, because the shops aren't there yet, even put it in front of shops that are empty, so that kids come up, parents come up with them, little carousels, things that you normally wouldn't see on a high street. But why not?
Hopefully, by celebrating the UK seaside heritage, I might also be able to entice the thousands of Turner Gallery visitors up the high street. I hope I can trial my inland pier concept. For one day, we could turn the high street into a leisure destination, a place where people could socialise, shop and have fun. Determined to try to help, I set off to Margate once again. Going on a summer holiday. As I step off the train in glorious sunshine, I'm surprised to find a distinct lack of day trippers.
We are now August. This should be packed with holidaymakers coming off the train. Little Bucket and Spade going up there. That is all that's got off the train. We are in beautiful weather, August. This train should have been packed.
Before I get to grips with my inland pier concept, I want to check on Billy and his ailing sweet shop.
The Billy is pure and look at him dancing. Billy! Hi! Entertainment.
Pan up.
Oh, good, Billy. Don't go too tight now. I never like the 15th dance. I'm rubbish at it.
No, I took that with myself.
He may be laughing on the outside, but I soon learn that after a recent extension, Billy has run into cash flow problems.
Oh, God, this feels so much more spacious.
And if you look carefully, it's not... It's not finished, but it's all I could do.
Then your money ran out?
Yeah, well, it sort of ran out before I finished this, really, as you can see. I mean, it was...
So you spent your pension?
Well, pretty much, yeah. I spent my pension and the few shillings I had lying about.
He's such a big character. You know, such a big character. Somehow you want this to be his emporium. You know, you want that to reflect that. And you can just feel it's been makeshift. And somehow... It doesn't feel enough in here. You know, there's not enough of a reason for me to think, I want to go into that shop.
And lack of holiday makers isn't Billy's only problem.
The chap around the corner's got the jump on me.
Who's the chap around the corner?
There's a shop down there that's recently opened, Mr. Sims. It's a traditional sweet shop.
Where are they?
They're just down here on the right hand side. Yeah.
When did they open? Did you know they were coming?
No.
His new rival has nailed what a sweet shop should be.
It's good. My God, and it's expensively shop-fitted as well, isn't it?
But it's great, isn't it?
My gut feel is, Billy, you're not going to be a sweet shop. That doesn't mean you can't have sweets in there. Mm. But we've got to think about what is the core thing we go to Billy's shop for. What does Billy's shop represent?
Billy's shop is at the entrance to the high street on the seafront, just moments away from the Turner Gallery. If he plays his cards right, this shop could be the essential souvenir stop-off for visitors to Margate. For inspiration, I suggest a quick tour into the Old Town area to see some of Margate's finer points.
Billy, this is divine, this area. This feels really wonderful.
Well, it's improved so much. And this is the local history museum. There you are, on the town coat of arms. Your name.
Portas Maris, Portas.
Let me help you. It means gateway to the sea.
Oh my God! Hang on, I have to hold on to my ring. People want their British seaside to be steeped in the history and nostalgia of the British seaside, and there is something around that that makes me think that's where your shop should be rather than just a sweet shop, you know?
Mm.
All that tweaking, all that naughty innuendo. I can see it. There's postcards, souvenirs, fun. Fun, entertainment, cheeky, irreverent. If we can sort of encapsulate that into the shop in some way, then I think that will give such a point of difference that people will go, let's go down to Billy's Kiss Me Quick Shop, because it just encapsulates all that's the spirit of Margate.
I now want to get to grips with the rest of Margate's High Street. A chance meeting with one of the town team members, Richard, gives me hope that we could continue to work together on the programme.
You know, hopefully we're becoming much more open and more welcoming to you and your team. And, you know, everybody in Margate is on board with you. You know, I absolutely assure you and promise you of that. We want to crack this thing on. We've wasted time. I don't want to waste any more time.
Things appear to be looking up. But unfortunately, this meeting contributes to another controversy.
And thanks for being so open and honest, sir.
All right.
I'm so sorry to find out that some of Margate's town team have resigned and that I've been implicated as one of the various reasons for their resignation. They've now decided to set up their own campaign team.
Last week, Margate's Portas Pilot Dreams turned sour when one of the town team members posted his resignation letter online saying, "I'm sorry, Margate." He said, "I can't continue to work in a situation where people are going away to hold secret meetings, publicly running down other town team members in front of the cameras. I feel as though I've been blackmailed, bullied and torn to shreds by team members. I don't deserve this." But I've not discussed anything about the Margate town team. I mean, there's this, you know, local mag that goes out, Thanet Watch, with a picture of me with my tongue sticking out saying, "Margate, Portas gives Margate a tip." And it's just negative, horrible, untrue stuff being said. It can all go away. There, didn't happen. Move on, onwards. I think.
To help the rejuvenation of Margate's High Street, I've come up with the concept of an inland pier. For one day only, the High Street will become an entertainment destination, tapping into our wonderful seaside heritage.
So the High Street becomes where the pier activity will be.
Yeah.
If it helps to increase footfall, I hope it'll provide some inspiration to the town team. After a period of difficulties, I've been asked to meet up with the new look town team for us all to make a fresh start. I'm meeting Richard and Terry, the new chairman.
Since the announcement of Margate winning the award, I think there's been an enthusiasm for Margate.
Yeah, yeah.
It's built up on the back of that.
Your name opens doors.
It
gets
their
attention. I think
that's
it
some slammed
really
in my face.
No, Terry.
There we go, Mary.
Some doors that have opened are the vacant shops on the High Street. Deals with landlords have made way for start-up businesses.
I know, it's a really good
space. Opens up. And this is what we're looking at for a multi-popper.
and there are 108 shops.
Yeah.
28 empty. Do you know what we have now?
How many?
15.
You've filled already that amount?
You...
Yeah,
you guys! Yeah,
and that's not just down to us. That's the council, that's the publicity you've given, that's working together with the local agents.
I'm eager to know what the guys will think of my inland pier concept and whether they'd give it a trial.
What I think this high street should be, wouldn't it be brilliant if we took this great road and kind of inverted the pier, as it were? And I love the idea of putting some of the activity that you'd get in a fun fair or in a dream here through the high street. Yeah. And then what happens? You create footfall, people are interacting, and now, by the way, they pop into a shop, they get a coffee, they get a bag of fish and chips. And I don't think there's any other high street that would be able to do this. I think yours is perfect.
A little bit of music.
It's bad. A little bit of music.
For the end of peer entertainment, I want to pull in something special. The legendary Chaz and Dave liked Margate so much they even wrote an anthem for it in the early 80s.
There's only one song we keep singing, Chaz, and it's yours.
To Margate.
Yes. You can keep the Costa Brava. I know all right, yeah. Will you come down and perform for us? It wouldn't be the same without you and Dave.
Well, Dave won't be able to make it, but I mean, I could make it if you could pay me expenses at least.
Yeah, we'll pay your expenses. What about Dave? Try and get him out. What's the matter with him? Why doesn't he want to come down?
No, he only does the odd one here and there.
Oh.
Well, it's about time you done an odd one in Margate.
Yeah.
You've done it. Well done.
With plans for a trial of the inland pier building, I now want to focus on something close to my heart, the transformation of Billy's souvenir shop.
I've got no idea where Mary's taken me today. I've been racking my brains all evening, all night, but it's one of life's mysteries.
I decide that a trip to Buckingham Palace and one of the most successful souvenir shops in the country could bring some inspiration.
Billy, look at you and your whistle.
My whistle.
Your whistle. Here we are. God, imagine that this is your home. It is totally and utterly breathtaking.
Wow, look at this.
So do you remember the Queen getting...
Yes, I do, yeah. It was a better year for the Queen than it was for me that year. I remember it very well. I was in a foster home, and we really didn't go on very well. As a matter of fact, we ran away from it. Me and my sister, I was 10, she was 11. Who would have thought I'd finish up in here? Now, this is a day that I'll remember for the rest of my life.
Oh, really?
It's just unbelievable.
Enthused by Her Majesty's manner, it's now down to business.
You've just walked out of here, and we've got all that history, all the beauty, all the wonderful heritage there that's all associated with our royal family. And what they do at the end of that is you walk through and they have the Buckingham Palace shop.
Even the Queen cashes in on her heritage.
And something like this is a really good seller because it's a pickup item and it's, you know, very well priced. Oh. And we sell tens of thousands of these and it just says has Buckingham Palace on it. You can put anything on it.
The rich heritage that comes out of the royals, it's just so many different things you can do with it. But we have to think about what the heritage of Margate is and what the messages of Margate are, right? And I was just thinking, you have a very, very famous Margate, living, incredible artist.
Well, of course, it's Tracy Emmons. She's a great ambassador for Margate.
Can you imagine if we asked Tracy to come up with what we think the Margate statement should be?
Yeah, she's the one.
You know Billy as well, don't you?
Yes, I do, yeah.
It's a big ask of a very famous artist, but she might just do that for you, Billy.
She might do, yeah.
few days later, Billy joins me back in London to visit Tracy Emin.
Hi, Tracy.
Hello.
Margate's most famous artist has agreed to come up with a brand idea that Billy can use to sell his products.
So the idea is, obviously, I wanted something which was kind of like Kiss Me Quick, something to do with Margate, whatever, something in my handwriting, you know, because it's like the neons and so definitive. Something short, because I thought it probably might go either on the hats or on rock or something like that, and so this is what I've come up with. For a dirty weekend, come to Margate.
It's fantastic.
It is what sets Margate apart, doesn't it? Like, yeah. As it's seaside town, there's something just that little bit naughty and dirty about it, a bit like you.
And what I would really like is that people go down to Margate, they go to Turner Contemporary, and they walk around, they go to your shop, they go here, they go there, and then they just have really good sex.
My gas is flabbered.
I should have said, for a dirty weekend, come in Margate, but I couldn't, that was too filthy.
When we're leaving Tracy's shop in London's trendy East End, I get another light bulb moment for Margate.
The East End, and the way that this place is with these great old vintage shops, bit of fashion, bit of food, there's something quite gritty and edgy about it, and I think Margate can be that too, I really do. It'd be great if we could do some sort of little, I don't know, some PR launch or something that would be in Margate sort of tone and let the people of London know what is down there.
It'd be great if it was advertised up here more, because I think people aren't, they're out of touch with what's happening down in Margate, aren't they? That's one of the problems.
Even back in the 1920s, Margate was trying to encourage jaded Londoners to jump on the train and spend a weekend retreat by the seaside. I have a plan to bring the London crowd back.
All these people milling around this station, and you kind of want to go, why don't you all go to Margate?
A weekend return to Margate is currently £31.10. I think that's a bit steep, so I've contacted South Eastern to see if they'll do a deal.
Margate has just lost its edge. And every time I travel down there, I think, why aren't more people going? And then I thought, well, how do I get some of these great Londoners down there who used to go, you know? So it would be beneficial if we were able to do a deal where I was able to get bums on seats if you were able to give a deal on the price.
Well, we'd like to try and do something for you. What we'd like to do is give you a limited edition fare of £10 return to Margate.
Blimey, that's pretty good.
We'll do something else for you.
Go on.
I know you're doing a Margate relaunch.
Yeah.
We'll also give you 500 free tickets for the Margate relaunch. So, there we are. There's your 500 free tickets.
I promise I won't go and sell these cheaply. I promise. I'm really honest. Thanks a lot.
With launch day approaching for the trial of the Inland Pier, I've got just a week to entice 500 Londoners down to Margate's High Street.
We're here to promote Margate, the famous...
Billy and some fellow Margate shopkeepers are in London's East End to drum up interest.
Portas is down there promoting Margate.
Got of it. I've never heard of it.
You've never heard of Margate before?
Hey, have you been to Margate before?
No.
Have you heard of Margate?
No.
I can't understand how so many people haven't heard of Margate. It's ridiculous, really. Obviously, we need to do the public relations today and get some people down to Margate.
With a bit of persistence and a helping hand from Tracy Emin's saucy invite, they eventually get some takers.
Would you like to go to Margate?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, I'll come.
Would you fancy going to Margate next Saturday?
Abso-fucking-lute. Can I say that?
On Saturday, there's going to be a big celebration of Margate up at the High Street, and it's all free.
Right.
Thanks a lot.
Cheers, thank you.
There's only 2 days before our publicity drive to try to put Margate's High Street back on the map. Local artists have taken over a couple of the empty shops to attract some of the 10,000 weekly visitors to the Turner Gallery. And the whole town is invited.
There's going to be rides for the kids, donkeys, and fortune
teller.
Yeah. And you know Chad's and Dave are?
Oh, yeah, of course they're there,
yeah. Chad is playing down here on Saturday, just over there. And Mary Portas, have you heard of Mary Portas?
Well, not
Queen
a Danish
shop.
We see her.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know. Well, blonde lady.
Redhead.
It's the day of the inland pier, at last, and the sun is shining. I'm on my way down from London, and this time the train is packed.
I've actually passed a full carriage. Couldn't go in because it was busy. Normally I've got the choice of any seat on anything.
The deal with the train company and Billy's PR drive has obviously worked.
So you've never been to Margate, you guys?
No, not in a long time.
I've been to Margate, let me tell you. You'll have to know the Margate song by the time we get to Chatham. Yeah. I know it.
What is it?
Well, I've been working hard to reach my target.
You can keep the cost of brother. I'm telling you, I'd rather have a day down Margate with the family.
There we are.
Oh, Billy.
Hello. Look at you.
Oh my God, you look amazing.
Do I?
Yeah.
I feel all right, fat. Oh, thanks so much for coming.
With help from the town team and the locals, the entrance to the high street has been transformed for the trial of my inland pier concept. There's a great mix of traditional seaside themed fun and even a couple of donkeys. The Turner Gallery's visitors are being encouraged to take a detour up the high street.
Lovely to see so many people about and extra things going on, and Margate is picking up.
We haven't had this many people out here for so long.
And it's great. And this is in the middle of winter.
Exactly.
You know, forget this. Continually, come summer, you'll be laughing.
Yeah. I'm hoping the town team will consider my inland pier idea on a more permanent basis.
I really just think it's so unique to what you do. No other high street will do this. And it's so
you've got to try and be unique.
Yeah. The inland pier, the high street where you can turn up and you've got the activities of the pier on it. It's unique.
Crowds are gathering for the opening of the town team's newly occupied indoor market.
This is Margate's micro department store, so I declare opportunity open of Margate. Oh. Yay. What's that?
And finally, before the tourists return home, they can stop off at Billy's new retro souvenir shop.
Oh, Billy.
What's it look like?
Looks fantastic. I feel quite emotional, do you? This is going to be the most important souvenir shop for Margate. It's the first little beacon that starts the high street regeneration. Come on, Billy. Darling, we just married.
Inside are nostalgic products and cool gifts, beautifully displayed in an all-white interior. And pride of place is Tracy Emin's new branding.
Matt, brilliant for a dirty weekend, come to Margate. Aye, aye, brilliant. Umbrellas, T-shirts. These are what, aren't they great? What do you think, guys? You like the shop?
Yeah, it's fantastic.
And then, of course, we have a little naughty section here.
Billy's Willy's lollipop, Mary's melons. Taste my dirty weekend. This is hidden behind the curtain so the children don't see. I'm feeling
sexy and free. And to make sure the hen market is still catered for, there's a photo booth complete with saucy props.
I just know that's going to make the flipping Margate pet papers.
I've had people coming up to me all the time telling me it's the first time they've been to Margate for 10 or 15 years and they're going to go back and tell their friends. And I've asked them, well, why haven't you come here before? And they said, because they've had bad publicity about the place. They thought it was a piss hole. Well, now they know it's real and they love it.
You know what? It's lovely to see the fun back in Margate. I wish I could have made a more permanent change in my time here. It's not what I dreamt when I came. However, publicity in itself can be a powerful thing.
It's going to take a while, but I think today what we've shown is that you just kind of light it, spark it, and it will start to travel.
But the day wouldn't be complete without the end of the pier entertainment, the legendary Chaz Without Dave.
Everybody all ready, are you? OK. Well, I've been working hard to reach me target. 250 for a day, been down to Margate. I'm gonna blow the lot tomorrow and all me family. Catch the coach and ace and I'll be like, we're off to see the street. Hurry up, your granddad, come on, we got down to Margate. Don't forget your buggers and spades and cottages and all.
If you're feeling inspired, head to channel4.com/Mary to find out how you could help bring your high street back to life. And we're building businesses tomorrow too, combining work and play in a location catch-up. That's at 8 o'clock. A change is coming to the Chatsworth next tonight. Shameless is on the way.